students, welcome to Misostudy and welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss that is chemical bonding. Few topic of chemical bonding. Chemical bonding. We know the force which bind two atom in a molecules or two or more atom in a molecules are known as chemical bond. Types of chemical bond. Yes, sir. This is first one is ionic bond, second one is covalent bond, third one is coordinate bond. Again I am repeating, first one is ionic bond, second one is covalent bond, and the third one is coordinate bond. Okay, now the thing, the important topic related to this chapter is MOT, molecular orbital theory, and how to find bond order. Clear? MOT and how to find bond order. Now moving here, I am giving you a technique to find the bond order in quick time without going through the MOT theory. Is it clear? Yes. Wait for a moment. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and the last one 20. Now mark like this: 1 0 1 0 1 2 3 2 1 0. Clear? Now suppose if anyone asks you to find the bond order of O2, O2 plus, O2 2 minus, N2, CO, CN minus, then B2, H2 plus, etc. Then how to find the bond order by using this table is very simple. Count the number of electrons. In case O2, this is a 16 electron system. Clear? Yes. Now count, where is 16? 16, below 16 there is 2, so the bond order is 2 here. So simple. Now the next one is O2 plus. This is the 15 electron system. Below 15 comes between 14 and 16, so the average, that is 3 plus 2 divided by 2, that is 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. now the next one is O2 2 minus, 18 electron system. 18, below 18 there is 1, so the bond order in this case will be 1. Now the next one we have N2, this is the 14 electron system. 14, below 14 what we have? 3. The bond order here is 3. Okay, now CO, 8 and 6 14, that is the 14 electron system. Below 14, that is we have 3, so bond order here is 3. Now CN minus, that is C6 6 plus 7 13 and 14, 14 electron system, below 14 this is 3. B2, 10 electron, yes, below 10 there is 1, so the bond order here is 1. Is it clear? Yes. Now H2 plus, only 1 electron, 1, here comes 1, no. So what will happen in this case, that is, in this case, that is 1s1, that is NB, sigma 1s1, that is NB 1 by 2, H2 plus has bond, bond order 1 by 2, half. Clear? Now MOT. By using MOT, how to write the electronic configuration? That is, we know sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, then pi 2px, pi 2py, sigma 2pz, so on. Suppose we, now nitrogen, write the electronic configuration. In this case, sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2px, then pi 2py. That is 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10, 2, 12, then 2, 14. This is the configuration. Now, by using this, how to find the bond order? Yes, sir. Bond order will be equal to 1 by 2 number of bonding electron minus number of antibonding electron. Bonding electron count, that is 2 here, that is 2 here, 2, 2, and 2. That is 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10, 10 minus 4. Antibonding electron star. 2, 2, 4, that will be equal to 1 by 2 into 6, that is equal to 3. So, the bond order of N2 is 3. Now, for more than 14 electron system, above 14 electron system, the electronic configuration is like this. Sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, sigma 2s, sigma star 2x, sigma 2pz, then pi 2px, then pi 2py, pi star 2px, then pi star 2py, then sigma star 2pz, so on. Clear? Yes. Now, in case of oxygen, fluorine, then what will happen in this case? Yes. In case of oxygen, fluorine, okay. We have O2, 16 electron system. We will fill like this. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, okay. Then sigma 2pz2, then pi 2px1, pi 2py1, then 2, then 2, then pi star 2px1, pi star 2py1, count. 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10, 2, 12, 2, 14, 1, 15, 1, 16, okay. Now, in this case, what will be the bond order? Bond order will be equal to 1 by 2 NB minus NA. NB, number of bonding electron. Count 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10. 10. Bonding electron 6, antibonding 2, 2, 4, 5, 1, 6, that is 1 by 2 into 4, that is equal to 2. Similarly, you can write the electronic configuration of O2 plus, O2 minus, this is a, generally MOT theory. Now, in this case, is it paramagnetic or diamagnetic? If unpaired electron, if there is a presence of unpaired electron, then it is paramagnetic, okay. Now, if I consider N2, now in this case, there is no unpaired electron, so N2 is diamagnetic. This is the use of MOT theory, clear? Now, next one, hybridization. Hybridization. What is hybridization? The formula of hybridization is equal to X is equal to 1 by 2 valence electron plus monovalent atom linked to the valence electron minus charge on cation plus charge on anion. Clear? This is the formula. Now, by using this formula, you can find the hybridization. For example, CH4. Now, the central metal atom carbon. Carbon has valence electron, tell me, 4. Monovalent atom 4 minus no charge, minus 0 plus 0. That is 1 by 2 into 8, that is equal to 4, and the hybridization is sp3. Hybridization is sp3. Now, the next one is ammonia, NS3. X is equal to 1 by 2, valence electron 5, nitrogen, monovalent atom 3, that is 1 by 2 into 8, that is equal to 4. Again, hybridization sp3. So, it is easy to find the hybridization, but the if hybridization sp3, then the geometry is tetrahedral. But sometimes we know the CH4 has tetrahedral geometry, but NS3 has, that is, pyramidal, and H2 also has sp3 hybridization, but the its shape is V shape. How do we predict? Yes, by using Vespar theory, VSEPR theory, we can easily predict the shape of the molecule. For example, if I consider CH4, now how to find, consider it, number of valence shell electron of the central metal atom 4, number of monovalent atom attached to it 4. So therefore total number of electron pair in this case 4 plus 4 8, there total number of electron 4 plus 4 8 divided by 2 pair, so total number of electron pair is 4. Clear? Number of bond pair, how many bonds are there, that is 4 bond. Number of lone pair is equal to 0, so that means to say the formula of CH4 is AB4L0. If AB4L0, then the shape will be tetrahedral. Clear? Now if I consider the next one, wait for a moment, if I consider NH3 ammonia, NH3, okay. Now in this case number of valence electron of central metal atom, that is 5, number of monovalent atom which is directly linked to hydrogen is 3. Clear? Now number of electron pair will be, yes, number of electron pair here is 5 plus 3 8 divided by 2, that is equal to 4. Clear? Now number of bond pair only 3, hydrogen linked to nitrogen, so now number of bond pair here is equal to 3. Number of lone pair will be equal to, yes, number of lone pair equal to total number of electron pair minus bond pair, that is 1. So the formula of NH3, that will be equal to AB3L1. If the formula, if the molecule having formula AB3L1, then it will have pyramidal shape. Clear? Now the next one is H2O, water. Okay? Now number of valence electron 6, number of monovalent atom 2, okay, number of electron pair here 6 plus 2 divided by 2, that is equal to 4, that is equal to 4. Clear? Number of hydrogen linked to oxygen 2, so number of bond pair is equal to 2. Okay, now what will be the number of lone pair? Number of lone pair will be equal to electron pair 4 minus 2, that is equal to 2. So what is the formula of the compound here, that is H2O, that is AB2L2. If the molecule having formula AB2L2, that is it will have V shape. So these three topic, these three important, these three topics from chemical bonding is very much important. Maximum number asked from this topic. So follow this, definitely help you a lot. Now my friend, this is just a theory class. I'm not going to extend this class. It's sufficient. Now be happy. Practice maximum will help you a lot. Till then, bye bye. Thank you so much.